Only 8 sites in Africa have yielded possible early anatomically modern Homo sapiens fossils from the late Middle Pleistocene. Most of these have considerable age uncertainty or debatable Homo sapiens apomorphy. The most widely accepted fossils that are interpreted as possessing unequivocal modern cranial apomorphies, that is, a tall cranial vault and a chin, and classified as Homo sapiens, are two Ethiopian finds, namely the Omo 1 and Herto specimens. We have spoken of the Herto man in our previous videos, so in this video we will be talking about the Omo 1 fossil. Accordingly, the evidence that constrains their ages assumes particular importance, but is a topic of considerable geochronological controversy. The Omo 1 remains were discovered in the late 1960s in the lower Omo Valley of southern Ethiopia at the surface of a siltstone near the top of member of the Omo Kibish Formation. In another eon, the Omo Kibish Formation of southwestern Ethiopia was home to several species of ancient humans. Our distant ancestors had plenty of reason to settle in what was then a fertile volcanic rift valley. Rainfall collected in lakes provided easy access to food and fresh water. Meanwhile, excavations from Omo Kibish show that the volcanic rock found throughout the region was an excellent material for tool making. Knowing this, it should come as no surprise, Kibish is known as a hotbed for hominin fossils and artifacts. Aside from numerous stone tools, the incomplete skeletons of at least two hominins were recovered from the sediment. Despite some small morphological differences, both were recognized as members of our own species, Homo sapiens, and relics of a crucial time in our evolutionary history. Remains from Kamoya's hominid site, KHS, were dubbed Omo 1, while from Paul 1 Abel's hominid site, PHS, were dubbed as Omo 2. Between Omo 1 and Omo 2, Omo 2 often has been described as possessing more primitive features. Unlike other Middle Pleistocene fossils, and Omo 1 possesses unequivocal modern human characteristics such as a tall and globular cranial vault and a chin. Determining the age of these ancient humans, which were called Omo 1 and Omo 2 and recovered during the 1960s, has proven challenging due to their deteriorated state. And yet, even with the limited means available, three different research projects from 2005 to 2012 determined their age to be remarkably old at around 197,000 years. Initially, it was thought to be just 35,000 years old, but in 2005, geologists had analyzed the layer of rock just underneath the findings, and more in-depth study has proved it to be way older than that. Now for the twist. Among archaeologists, the Omo Kibish Formation in Ethiopia is known as a hotbed for hominin fossils, like I said, and Omo 1 was previously dated to around 197,000 years. Now a new study places its age at 230,000 years. The researchers arrived at their conclusion by studying volcanic sediment rather than the bones themselves. Date was calculated by analyzing the layers of ash deposited on the fossils. A more precise date means to analyze the thick layers of ash. Earlier, it was nearly impossible as ash was so fine. However, availability of more refined methods made the team to link ash layer to an eruption of Shala volcano. Findings published in Nature crowned Omo 1 the oldest Homo sapiens fossils in eastern Africa and a strong contender for some of the oldest remains of Homo sapiens in the entire world. The research project was not carried out by paleontologists but geographers. This is because, rather than attempting to date the fossils themselves, it was decided to date the sediment atop the fossils instead. doing so would not reveal Omo 1's exact age. However, it would provide researchers with a reliable estimate for the fossil's minimum age, as the bones could never be younger than the ground layer above them. For their tests, the researchers collected volcanic rock at Omo Kibish, not far from where Omo 1's remains were found. This porous rock, created by the solidification of gas-rich lava that originally may have come from the Shala volcano 400 kilometers away, was ground down to sub-millimeter size. The researchers explain that once you've crushed the rock, you free the minerals within and then you can date them. The minerals were dated to 230,000 years, meaning the remains buried underneath the volcanic ash must be slightly, if not significantly, older. Though not entirely unexpected, the results were nonetheless astounding. The newly estimated age of Omo 1 casts previous assumptions into doubt. The Omo Kibish 1 skull is significant because it provides important insights into the evolution of Homo sapiens. Prior to its discovery, most of what was known about early humans comes from fossils that were tens of thousands of years younger. The Omo Kibish 1 skull is one of the first pieces of evidence that suggests that anatomically modern humans had evolved much earlier than previously thought. The findings, while convincing, won't settle the debate on human evolution because, in the words of the scientists, the study of human evolution is always in motion. Boundaries and timelines change as our understanding improves. These fossils show how resilient humans are, that we have survived, thrived, and migrated in an area that was so prone to natural disasters. Having determined the minimum age of Omo 1, the study says the next objective should be to assess maximum age. Given that Homo sapiens is believed to have emerged in the same region where Omo 1 was found, researchers hope the dating of other layers of volcanic ash throughout the rift might help paleontologists fill in the gaps of our evolutionary history. And this is where the video ends, guys. I hope you liked the video and thanks for watching. Please do not forget to support us by liking our videos and subscribing to the channel. Till then, this is Halabella and see you soon in our next video.